Hello, my creative friends. I have a little fun tutorial for those of you who have my watercolor set. And if you don't, you can go to my website at erisklein.com, or you can go to Eris Klein Designs on Etsy. So let's go ahead and have some fun with these watercolors. I'm going to do an abstract nature scene. I'll start a little color palette here. I like to take an airbrush and then build a little color palette. So on this layer, my very first layer, I'll just rename it color palette. There we go. I have a vegetable green, a light vegetable green, a tan, and sort of a reddish orange brown burnt sienna look. And I will go ahead and create a new layer and pull it down to the bottom here. And this layer, I'm just going to call my watercolor abstract, because I'm going to create a very watercolory abstract background. Let's start with the slippery color and see what it does. Okay, so I'm already in the browns, and why not? I'll just go ahead and start there. And now you're probably wondering, why is it coming out green? And that's because this is a color changing brush. So every time I lift my brush, it changes color. All right, so think abstract, think playful, and just lay down a little bit of color. And then I'm going to go ahead and play with the next brush, which is in the wet watercolor, the feathered stroke brush. Okay, so what I'm going to say about some of the watercolor brushes, and this is one of them, in the feathered stroke brush, some of the watercolor brushes, not just in my set, but in every set that you'll get, is that some of them, the light colors will not show on top of the dark colors because it's acting like water. And what color is water? It's transparent. So see, if like I use white, you can't see it. But I've got a little trick for you. If you're gonna use a lighter watercolor over your other watercolor, then just create a new layer on top and do your light color there, and look, there it is. I've heard people struggle with that, and that's your solution. And what I like about the feathered stroke is, look at this. This looks a lot like watercolor that comes in and it kind of frays and blends into the other color, because it's like you have two pools of watery watercolor and they start bleeding into each other. There we go. There's my abstract watercolor background. And I could go ahead and group these layers by just selecting them and swiping to the right so they're all highlighted, and say group. And I will name that group my abstract background. There we go. And then there's a little arrow here. I'll just close it up so I can keep my layers organized. And then while that's highlighted, I'm going to put a layer right above it. And this is where I'm going to start to put some nature. So I will name this one. Let's do some sort of leaves. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to create a couple pieces of foliage or leaves, and we'll make clipping masks out of them. So to do that, we're going to just go to your sketch and blend brushes and just get your technical pen. Let's do that. And with that, let's see, I'm just going to use black so that I can see what I'm drawing. And I'm going to draw out some forms here. So I'm just kind of figuring out where the leaves are going to be going and how they're going to be getting progressively smaller as I go up. And then I'll go ahead and build my sort of long skinny leaf forms here. Wait a minute, I don't have to turn the iPad. I just turn the paper. Okay, that's what I love about digital painting. Okay, now when I create these, I want to make sure to not have any gaps, because then what I can do is just take my finger, grab this, and you have to do it kind of quick. See, it already turned to white. And I don't, okay, let's turn it back to black. Thank you very much. There. Okay. And you can fill these areas. It's sort of like a quick grab and pull. Now, if you have a form that's not closed, look what happens. It fills the whole space. So that's why you want to use the technical pen, is it's really solid and has no texture and has no gaps. And now it's up to you, though, to also draw with no gaps. So make sure that that form is completely closed, and then you can take and quickly pull it. And put it in there. Come on. There we go. Voila. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm just going to go ahead and keep doing this. All right, there's my leaf form number one, and I'm going to make it a little smaller. So I click the little arrow where I can make adjustments, and I'm going to have it on uniform. And there is your first leaf mask. Let's create one more. So I'll create a new layer, and this will be leaf number two. Okay. All right. So leaf number two. Let's see. I think I'll turn this one off so I can see where I am. If it helps, you can actually lock all the layers that you're not working on so that you don't accidentally work on the wrong layer. And I'm going to go ahead and create maybe a whimsical leaf, I don't know. Okay. All right, so let's see. I'm going to position my two leaves with each other. And obviously one's going to have to move. Let's see, I'm going to move this one. Okay, leaf one, leaf two. And I'm going to put a clipping mask above each of these and paint some watercolor into these guys. So let's see. So I'll go ahead and what do I want to do? Oh, the first thing I want to do is turn each of these completely white instead of black. So, you can go into the little magic wand here, adjustments, hue, saturation, brightness, and just pull the slider brightness all the way to white. So do that for each of them. Whoops, the little magic wand, hue, saturation, brightness, and move that all the way to white. There we go. Okay, so we want them to be a white background. Now, go to leaf number one. Add a layer, click that layer, and look for clipping mask. There it is, clipping mask. And you'll see a little arrow appear on the left-hand side, and that means now it is a clipping mask to whatever the layer is below it. So when I paint on this layer, it will only paint on leaf number one, and everything outside of it is masked. Masked. So, okay. So let's give it a shot here. I think I'll turn off leaf number two so I don't have to look at it. And I'm going to focus on this guy over here. And now I'm going to just play with all kinds of different watercolor textures and so forth within the set. So maybe I'll even go to start with texture and try the sea sponge first. Okay, for me, I'm liking this, but I'm not liking how it's reacting to the background. So what I could do is play with adjusting the color, and that would be under the little magic wand there, adjustments, hue, saturation, brightness. And hue is just all the colors of the rainbow. So if I slide it around, it gives me different colors. Hue is another word for color. Saturation is how vibrant or how dull the color is. See, I can go all the way to just gray. And then darkness, so dark and light. Let's see, I think if I just darken it a little, it's going to show. I don't know. That's not bad either. So play around with that and see what works for you. That to me is totally out of the color range, so I don't want to do that. I want to keep the harmony going. Brown doesn't look bad, but I was thinking of spring leaves. Oh well, such is life. All right, so that's one down and one more to go. So let's see, I'll go ahead and lock these layers by swiping to the left, go up to leaf number 2. Do you remember what you do to create a clipping mask? You're gonna create a new layer, then you're gonna select that layer, then you look for clipping mask. And then you see a little arrow there, and then whatever's down below it, that's what it's going to use as the basis for its mask. And there it is. So I'm going to turn this one off so I can see this one right here. I'll just focus on leaf number 2, and there's the mask above it. Okay, so I'm on the mask right above leaf number 2. And now that I know that darker colors kind of look nice, I'll use darker colors. And this time, maybe I'll play with the feathered stroke again. I'm going to try that and use, I'm tempted to try some browns. Now I'm just going around and trying different brushes. This is a great opportunity to play. There really is no right or wrong way. It's just a matter of what you like and just exploring. Okay. All right. So once again, I'm finding this is getting lost in the background. So I'm going to go ahead and on my clipping mask, I'm going to click the little magic wand, go to hue, saturation, brightness, and see what I can do. I sort of like that berry look. Okay, so let's just see how these are looking. Maybe I need to change my background a little bit and lighten it up. All right, I like that. That's starting to look good. And then what I would do is once you like your layout, I would go ahead and flatten your clipping mask. So I'll go up to the first clipping mask and just say merge down. So that's leaf number 2. And then I go to the next clipping mask. Oops, it's locked. And merge it down. And now these are merged, and I can go in and do some refinement. Because see how these edges are really hard? Because I use the technical pen, right? So now I could go in here and make them softer and more random. So I might try the actual smudge tool and go back to that wonderful wet watercolor, the feathered stroke. That gives some really beautiful feathery looks. So let's see, I think I'll turn off the background. Okay, there we go. And you can see that that's making it much more like a watercolory edge. And I don't just go in and do every single edge, I kind of do it randomly. I'm tempted to give this background a little bit of some drips. So I'm going to go into textures and get some my drippy stamp. Thank you. All right, we're getting there. I'm tempted to do one more layer and go to the dried edge brush. Let's try that one. Oh yeah, that's cool. Maybe I'll do some here. Okay, I'm gonna move that down into the abstract layer. Okay, I'm starting to like it. I need to work some of these other areas a little bit and soften the edges. But otherwise, I'm really starting to like this abstract. So go ahead and give the watercolors a try. Try some of these techniques. And this is a great way to just really dive into the set and experiment and get a feel for what these can do. And in the end, you might be the next person creating abstract nature prints that you're selling on Etsy. Congratulations for learning how to use my Procreate brush sets. And hit subscribe to learn about new and upcoming brush sets and fun tutorials for Procreate and Adobe Fresco.